Hello YouTube, today we got the bread and butter of this operation. This is a Lenovo Legion Y540-15IRH-PG0. The model name is 81SY. The problem with all of them is always the same, is the connector right here. Keep in mind that not only the connector goes bad, but also the cord right here goes bad as well. Now, one thing to understand is we're gonna replace the piece inside, but we can't really do much about the cord, because if we chop this guy off and put another tip on this, we got a bunch of those tips. Well, I have a bunch of those tips like that. All right. The problem is, Lenovo made it so that it would be impossible to replace this tip with another tip, because this tip has a little chip inside, a diode or a resistor, go figure. I don't know exactly what it has inside. But the problem is, I can't just chop off this guy and put another cord on this, because the laptop not gonna work. The reason the Lenovo did that, so you wouldn't be shoving any aftermarket parts inside, and so that you would spend hundreds of dollars on those OEM Lenovo 20 volts 230 watt adapters. The number one complaint that we get from the clients that send us this laptop is that they sent it to us without the power supply. We fix the jack, we ship it back to them, and they say it still wiggles, it still doesn't work. The reason it wiggles is because the cord right here is probably bent, or the chip inside is already bad. I can see right here it moves a little bit right here, and I can't really do much about it. So the jack I'm gonna replace, but the power supply, you probably will have to buy another power supply like that someplace else. I don't have them in stock, and I can't really do anything about that tip being such a hard find. I was able to fix one tip, but it took me about 2 hours to fix it, and it's not worth my time, because I usually fix it at no extra charge. So let's take it all apart. No, let's add a little bit more light. Alrighty, keep in mind that the screw sizes are different here. And here we got the smaller screws, here, 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 here. And those are the longer screws right there at the top. Some screws don't want to come out by some reason. This is the long screw right here. Another long screw. And another long screw. And another long screw right there. Okay, good job. Now, here is the tricky part. And what most of the clients don't understand is, you have to be extremely careful and try and pry this side right here first. You see right where this connection is at. And then it's gonna come right out. So start from the side. All right. And now you have to do this side as well. Don't pull on it too hard. It should come out right by itself. Easy. Okay. Sometimes there are two LED lights right here, and there are two cables running to the motherboard, but not on the system. Again, we've seen so many, you know, I mean, just look at our channel. We got about a dozen of those Legions. And if you miss something in this video, The reason I'm remaking this video is because now we got a 4K camera, we got professional lights, we got a better, how you call it, the better. Here, you know what, first thing I need to tell you is that don't pull on the cord right now because you might scratch the motherboard here and there. So what you do is unscrew that screw. All right, so once you unscrewed those screws, remove the battery and pull on this cord this way, like that. All right, because if you're going to be trying to catch it with the screwdriver or something, you're going to scratch the motherboard. I did it once and I didn't mess it up, but because my screwdriver is anti-scratch, but I took the paint off in the top. And this is not something that I want to deal with again. So this is applies to all of the Lenovo Legions. Again, we got all of them. So if the Y540 is not your model, we got here Y545, 17 inches, 15 inches, 55i, 77i. Again, just look on our channel Legion. Just type in Lenovo Legion, and I'm sure there's gonna be a video about your particular model. It seems like this fan was replaced, or maybe it doesn't spin at all because this is not dirty at all, but this one is really dirty. All right, and I got some dirt in my eyes for some reason from the dust, from talking too much here. All right, so we need this and we need that right here. Now, the first thing we're gonna do is we're just gonna disconnect this guy right here. Let's zoom in a little bit so you would see everything much better. Can you see? Yeah, okay. So 4K camera, but the lights are not really exactly. This camera doesn't like my new lightning system, light system. Let's see if you're gonna add more light like that. Maybe it's gonna like that like. The like that like. Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to go above and beyond here. So if a like wouldn't be too much trouble, it's always appreciated. All right, so here we're just going to remove this cable right here. Next thing we're going to do is remove this wireless card. All right, and set the wireless card and a screw for it separately. Here we got the screw right there. All right. Here we're gonna do a separate SSD drive. All right, and because of so much dust on it, you wanna clean it up. Ooh, do you see that loose screw right there? That's one of the reasons why the whole board fails. Oh, look at that. What's that? Another metal part flying all over the board. Anyways, I just disconnected the SSD. All right. Hopefully, I really hope that the laptop didn't short out because of this stuff. You see right here? You see the screw? This shouldn't be like that. Hopefully, it didn't short anything. But I seen the screws flying all over the motherboard on the prior Lenovo Legion. So sometimes maybe it's not the jack, sometimes maybe it's just screw flying around and shorting the motherboard in your case. So be, you know, if you take it apart and you see some screws flying around, just remove the screws, and it's still probably not gonna work because once it's shorted, all right? Okay. So let's continue with the program. Here you wanna remove that, disconnect that. Disconnect the CMOS battery like that. Alrighty, here we got a touchpad going here. We want to disconnect this guy right here. Alright, and we want to disconnect this guy right there. Take that aside. Most of you would say we don't need to remove the hard drive, but I'm just gonna remove it. All right. right, so I got the hard drive removed. Almost. Give me 1 second here. Like that. All right, so the hard drive is removed right now. All right. Let's see if you can just screw that missing screw back to where it came from. All right, so we got that. This one is also loose. Let's see. For some reason, all four of them are loose. So all four of them could short the motherboard in the future. Next thing you want to do is disconnect those guys right here. All right, like that, okay. Here we got one and two for the bracket. You want to set this aside. And we got a hidden screw right here someplace. Alrighty. So we set that hidden screw aside. It's a long one. That's a long one. Right here we got, wow, we got, ooh, wow, look at this motherboard right here. You see this? This bent the motherboard pretty bad. Alright, and I'm not sure if it's even gonna be workable, because this is not the way how it's supposed to be. Maybe if I remove the USB altogether, it might work fine. Here one. And two right there. However, we still need to remove the heatsink, because there is no easy way to take this whole thing out. Okay. Yeah, so here is the trick. When you're unscrewing all the screws, make sure you're gonna keep the heatsink downward pressure with this finger right here. All right, so much money been invested in this 4K experience, but I think it's not as good as I meant it to be. All right, here you want to clean the heatsink in those grooves right there. We've got all the extra stuff. All right, here all the dirt. Alright, you are going right there. Yeah, so strange that this is a clean one right here, but that one is dirty. Alright. Let's get this guy right here. Yeah, clean as a whistle. Strange. Alright, so what I want to do is I want to clean the heatsink and the GPU. And I want to move this guy slightly upwards. Like that. And yeah, let me clean up this guy. Okay. The jack is obviously broken, as if you take a look right here. I mean, it just falls apart. I just basically touched it a little bit. And that's basically bread and butter, and I hope I'll be able to buy Mercedes-Benz one day thanks to this Lenovo laptops. Because back in the days, Asus was the bread and butter, but now Lenovo Legion is the bread and butter because they make powerful laptops. They learn from the best on how to make laptops so that in a year or so the jack would break or some other part would break. And that's the reason I am in business, and I want to say thank you to everyone who was designing such an advanced laptops. Yeah. I mean, there's easy ways to make money, for example, test kits for something. You know, instead of fixing, we just do testing. Those of you who are around in 2020, 2021, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Yeah, this is all hard way of making money. This, you have to actually work here. You know, smell all this stuff. Chemicals and solder. And this anyways, let me pause the video because I'm gonna clean this thing up. Alright, so I cleaned up the heatsink. Here's the reason I'm showing you that, so you would compare yours to this one. You should understand that all of those guys are exactly where they need to be. So if yours are not exactly like that, make sure. Okay, let me clean up. Alright, so make sure that the pads are sitting exactly where they are, because once you miss a pad or two, the system might overheat and that component might fry. Fry. There used to be a store called Fry Electronics. Now I know exactly why. Because everything was fried eventually. Anyway, so here is what I'm trying to do is this. Just trying to lift up this guy. Okay. All right, so here's one more screw right here. All right, and let's lift this guy up. And there is another cable right here, which I keep forgetting about to connect it back when I'm putting everything together all the time. Hopefully I won't forget about it on this system. Anyway, so that's your broken jack right here. We're just gonna use some Captain tape on this side. The link to the Captain tape is below. I'm gonna insulate the LED LCD connector right here. Also, what I want to do is I want to remove this this ribbon cable right there. On this side, we have to use the Captain tape right here. Obviously. Okay, like that. And we have to use this right here. Okay, like that. Wonderful. All right. And okay, so this is 600 degrees, this is 300 degrees. And everything seems to be covered just fine, except maybe... No, let's put another 600 degrees on top of the 300 degrees. I don't think it's gonna make it 900 degrees, but it should be good. Yeah, like that. All right. You know what? It has tendencies to fly off, so I'm just gonna put another thermal tape, Captain tape on top, like that. I wonder if I reposition the light, because this is nasty. This looks good, right? So maybe, oh, in that way it's, I see, so like that, Wow, you can see the reflection in the light. About like that. Oh, I see. So maybe the angle with which the light gets onto the motherboard should be slightly different. Alrighty, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna add some flux at the front, in the back. Let's flip it over. Oh, we can actually add some flux right here as well. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna add some solder to the equation. We're gonna add some leaded base solder. And the leaded base solder gonna mix with the unleaded base solder, and it's gonna drop the melting temperature for us. And we would be able to just pop this guy right out of there. All right. Alrighty. Alright, so doesn't want to come out easy for some reason. Oh, alright, my heat is on minimal. Let's remove that. Let's add some heat. Let's remove this guy right out of there. Alright. Like that. And like that. The plastic smells extremely bad. So I do prefer to take the whole thing out together, because it's much easier when everything is connected, because everything comes out right away. But here, nothing good is coming out altogether. Well, let's just do something like that. And right there is one stuck right there. Anyways, let's reduce the heat. All right. Let's add some, let's use the desoldering wick for the soldering. All right. All right, you see everything is nice and empty, so we can easily put a new we can put a brand new jack in place. I'm inspecting right now to make sure that none of the nearby components flew off the motherboard, and all of them seem to be just fine and seem to be in the right places. All right, so let me bring a new jack. All right, so what we do here is we're just gonna add some flux right there, right there, right there. Alright, and then we're just gonna pop a brand new connector right here. Make sure it sits pretty well inside. And let's add some solder into the equation right there. And right there. Good job, like that, those are the minuses on the side, and let's add some to the plus right here. All right, let's flip this guy over. By the way, I probably want to remove the extra tape around here. Let's flip this guy over. And let's solder this guy like that. All right, good job. All right, looks good to me. Let's clean this guy up a little bit. Like that. I need to remove some solder from the from the motherboard right here. Next solder from the connection. All right. And let's add some ISP here. Let's clean up the ISP a little bit. All right. Beautiful. All right. Good job. Okay. Excellent. That way nothing's going to be corroded here. All right, so let's look at this guy right here. You see this damage? Yeah, this is exciting damage. Yeah, this is just nasty damage. Let's see what we can do here about this. Right, needed to clean up a little bit. Let's see if we can just... Oh, wow. Did you see this? Yeah, that's insane. I don't think anything gonna work like that here anymore. Strange, how does something like that happens? So anyways, let me remove this connector altogether, maybe... Maybe that was the problem. Oh. And I just don't want this connector to short anything else on the laptop. I know. The more good deeds I do, the worse it becomes at the end. So it's like no good deed goes unpunished, but sometimes I just have to interfere, you know. Some people just use cam without interfering. Some people get stuff done. Some people just watch. Others need to get stuff done. And this is just horrible. You don't have to deal with it. Probably you don't have a problem like that. But I just need to get this connector out. Because this is not the way how things are done here. Alrighty. doesn't want to come out. This board is extremely thermal, dissipates the thermal heat really well. So this is just wonderful. Just trying to straighten this thing out, but no luck. All right, got that thing done. Alrighty, so let's put it all back together. We want to flip this guy over. Let's connect this thing right here. Close this guy right like that. Do we have anything else here to install? Nope, not really. Alright, so all of the guys are all the way out of here. All right. And okay. Okay, so let's zoom out a little bit here. Probably the focus is gonna go out of focus. Okay, so one screw gonna go right here. All right, another screw gonna go right here. Ooh, you know what I forgot? I forgot exactly what I was told you about. What I told you about. I forgot to connect that cable that I always forget to connect. So let's disassemble this guy one more time. Okay, let's flip the motherboard over. Let's put some support right here under the motherboard. Let's connect this cable like that. And like that. If only I would know what that cable is for. All right, like that. Now, without putting any pressure on that cable, we're just flipping this whole thing over. And like that. Yeah, like that. Like that. This cable is here. This cable, CMOS battery is right here. Like that. Wonderful. Here we're gonna... Now let's first connect this cable right here. And put it under right there. Like that. Like that. Yeah, let's see, like that. Okay. Okay. All right, so that's that one going in right there. You got this thing going in right here. And you got two screws. One right here. And one right there. One screw going in right here. All right, a long black screw going in right there. Okay. Next thing is, we're gonna install the hard drive right this place, right here. All right. Okay, so for the hard drive, we got four screws. I think those are the right screws right here. Okay. Alrighty. We wanna realign the cable. Make sure it's nice and straight. Usually there should be a metal bracket here, but I don't see the metal bracket anywhere. Hold on, maybe it's left on the soldering table. Nope, it's not on the soldering bench. Alrighty, so here we got the the SSD drive. All right, so here what I want to do is I want to put some tape to make sure that the cables are not going to fly off the motherboard anywhere. All right, and now I want to put some thermal paste right here and right there. However, first I just want to double check that there is a resistance here on the positives, resistance on the data signal, and no resistance on the negatives. So looks good to me. Now here I can't really check anything because I don't know which one is what and what does what. But I want to put some tape on it as well because this is not this isn't the way how it's supposed to be. All right, so that's that right here. Hopefully it didn't cause by the people who were opening, trying to open it up before. Let's put some thermal tape, not tape, thermal paste right there and right there. Okay, so here, let's do Alrighty. And here, make sure the pads look exactly like that on your end. And now we are able to just drop this whole thing top down. Like that. Like that. Good job. Okay. Let's start with the number one. Where is the number one here? 3. Oh, that's the number one. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just pre-tightening it. Like that. All right, looks good to me. Let me just double check one more time. Everything is nice and tight. Again, I'm not sure if the laptop gonna work with the damage like that right here, but hopefully it will. Hopefully. Just hopefully. Okay, so we got that here. Now let's bring the... You know what, I think this is not the right screws right here. Those are not the right screws. Those should be silver screws, I think. Let's connect the silver screws. Yeah, looks good. Let's close down the cover. For some reason there's a dent here, which is not supposed to be there. But I'm not surprised about this model, about this laptop. I mean, about this particular laptop at all. Alright, so let's see if we can... Alright, so here... You see, this thing is broken off. Right. All right, so that seems to be it. Let's see if it's gonna power up and work. Right, nice and tight. We got a light right here. Light is always good. We got the light right here. Let's power it up. Well, wait, I got Legion on the screen right there. Legion. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe. I will let you know which laptops I would spend my money on. Here, I want to show you that the battery is charging right there. You see? All right. Oops. So, yeah, thanks so much. And you guys take care and have a good day. Thank you.